Another modern feature unique to PyVision is support for event frames. Our previous well pad detail display included the 30-day average downtime for each one of its wells, but on our oil well detail display, it would be even better if we could explore and track each one of the downtime events for that well, complete with start and end times and reason codes for the downtime event. Here's where the events table comes in. Similar to how the asset comparison table allows us to view multiple assets simultaneously and compare their attribute values, the events table allows us to view multiple events simultaneously and compare their attribute values. To the left of the asset pane and graphic library, in between the assets and graphics icons is the event pane. By default, the events pane lists all the events related to assets currently on the display that were active at any point between the start and end time of the display. But we can change this behavior by editing the search criteria. For example, let's say we want to view all events active within the last 2 months. We can update the time range to have a start time of star minus 2 months and an end time of star. When we're happy with our search criteria, we can effectively convert this list of events into a table that resides on the display using the Create Events Table button. The makeup of this table may then be adjusted to our liking. In the Configuration pane, we'll deselect the Asset and Acknowledgement columns because our display only concerns one asset and our events don't support acknowledgements, and we'll instead include the Duration and Reason columns. To match the design language of our display, we'll change the style of the table to use the lighter color scheme. You may have noticed already, but our table is currently returning all types of events associated with this oil well. But we're really only interested in downtime events, so let's filter our results down a bit. Under the Edit Search Criteria section of the Configuration pane, we'll add an event name masking filter to only include events that contain downtime in their names. Now that we're done configuring the table, let's adjust its position and resize it a little so that it fits nicely beneath the production rate versus power consumption trend and that no text is cut off. If any of our events interest us, we can right-click on the corresponding row in the events table and select Apply Time Range to take the start and end time of the event and apply it to the start and end time of the display. Our display then reflects the operating conditions during the time the event was active. If this helps us to understand why the downtime event occurred, we can enter a reason code for the event by clicking the pencil graphic in the reason column for this event and then select a code from the list. In this example, our event occurred due to a pump breakdown, so we'll expand the breakdown reason and select pump. Our display is almost complete. The last step will be to update our display context switching settings so we can quickly switch between any of our oil well assets. To do this, open the asset dropdown at the top of the display and search for the configuration icon. We'll then set the context switching type to show search results and adjust the search route to North Dakota and check return all descendants. By default, returning all descendants will return all elements underneath the North Dakota asset, which would include our well pad assets as well. Since we only want our wells to show up, let's add an asset type filter by using the dropdown to select well. When we return to the asset dropdown at the top of the display, we can see all of our North Dakota wells populate the list, and selecting any one of them will immediately update the context of the display, repurposing the prior display we made to an entirely different well.